Hello guys, in today's episode, we're going to be talking about five of the most common mistakes people make when they're still starting out with Axure RP. Let's get started. So in case you missed it, our last episode, we chatted a little bit about what Axure RP is. What do people use it for? Who uses Axure? How much it costs and what you can create with Axure. If you wanna see that video, you can check it out. It should be linked somewhere around here. In any case, in today's episode, we're talking about five of the most common mistakes people make when they're still starting out with Axure RP. So let's get started. Number one is labeling components. Now, to be perfectly honest, I still make this mistake myself. I tend to forget to label. When you're still starting out, labeling components can be very tricky and may not be the most exciting thing to do.
I just got bored, everybody out.
The reason why labeling is such a big thing is that when you're trying to differentiate between components, it becomes very difficult. By default, Axure uses native component names like rectangle or circle, but does not differentiate them by a number. This becomes a problem when you have to add interactions to the components that you've created, but you cannot differentiate between similar shapes. So a good way to approach labeling is to use a format that I use, that is like feature, component, color, and a number. So for instance, you could have a button, which is an add to cart button, blue, version 2.
Red soldiers, we're falling apart in the DMZ!
Oh, geez, I am so sorry. Someone put the story in all capital letters and I thought I was supposed to yell it.
It's up to you how you want to label your components, but make sure they're descriptive and it helps you differentiate between different components that you have on the page. Number two, not using grid lines. When you're still starting out, you tend to create your wireframes very fast. And what happens is shapes and components end up misaligned on the actual page. And a good way to neaten and tidy up your layout is to use grid lines. The way you go about doing this is by switching on rulers under view, rulers, grids, and guides, and then switch on show rulers, snap to guides, and show grid. Then drag out the guides to mark the edges. This enables you to align everything on the page and neatens up your work and makes it look bit more professional. So in my case, whenever I start any Axure project, I tend to switch on my rulers, set up my guides on the page, and then I can align everything I create to those guides. Number three is not using masters. So at the beginning, you tend to use the native default library that comes with Axure. Axure has icons and default components that you can drag and drop onto the canvas. But as you start to build out bigger projects which have multiple pages, it makes a lot of sense to have repeatable or reusable components. One way of doing that is to create masters.
Do you want to learn Kung Fu?
Yeah.
Then I am your master.
Okay.
So masters are reusable components that you have in your project, and these may range from buttons, headers, footers, to even forms or entire pages. Using masters then allows you to speed up your process and stops you from starting from scratch every single time that you begin with a new page. The way you go about doing this is by right-clicking any component or group of components and choose create a master. The masters are then housed in a master panel from where you can drag and drop onto multiple wireframes and pages. Number 4 of the most common mistakes people make when getting started with Axure RP is to create overly complex interactions in their Axure prototypes or their wireframes. Now, this is a mistake that both beginners and seasoned professionals make in trying to make a hyper-realistic final product.
This isn't real.
What is real?
I think what's important to realize is the core idea behind rapid prototyping is to develop concepts and ideas as fast as possible by focusing on only what is necessary. Subtle interactions, limited functionality, and page transitions may be enough to do the job. So try as much as possible to make your features small, manageable, and able to convey the ideas that your prototype is meant to do. A great way to get around overly complex interactions is to firstly define what fidelity or level of detail that you're going to work with across your project. Is it going to be a low-level detail prototype wireframe, or is it going to be a much higher fidelity wireframe or prototype? When I started, I began with low fidelity wireframes, and this is because I was still learning the trade, I was still learning the tool, and it gave me enough time to figure out my style as well. Now, as a senior designer, I have a bit more ability under my belt to do much higher level detailed actual prototypes and wireframes. The last mistake that I want to share with you is using images and colors way too early during the wireframing and prototyping stages. Unless specifically asked for, images, fonts, and colors usually detract from what your work is trying to convey. You don't want clients and your team members focusing on the wrong things, right? So let's say you get stuck because we're discussing the image in the header banner as opposed to the information that should be on the page to make the page much more effective. And this can lead to a lot of unproductive meetings and numerous iterations as the project goes on. As a general rule, wireframes are grayscale to show the layout, the priority of information, the information architecture, and the functionality. Where it's possible, try to have separate meetings about imagery and aesthetic much later in the project.
Okay, cool.
And that's it for 5 of the biggest mistakes that you can make when getting started with Axure RP. If you enjoyed this video, please consider liking, commenting, or even sharing this video. It helps me understand what sort of content to create next. Question of the day: what mistakes have you made in your projects? Leave that in the comments down below, and I'll be looking forward to reading them. In the next video, I'll be sharing with you 3 of my first prototypes that I created in Axure for commercial clients. And I don't mind telling you, they were not pretty. But we're definitely gonna have lots of fun at my expense. Anyways, enjoy your day and catch me in the next video. Bye.